Hey Star Wars fans, FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net, giving you an HD widescreen look at Sideshow Collectibles Commander Neyo. This is one which has been, a few people managed to get this a little early from Sideshow. Our shipments here were just a little bit slower, so they've kind of pipped the post, but he's been around for a while and he's certainly still out there. So if you want to get this guy, we'll put a link directly underneath the video and make sure you head there, because he's pretty damn cool. Commander Neyo, as we said, 91st Reconnaissance Corps, 12-inch or 6/1/6 scale, and he's pretty cool looking, that's for sure. The box is the usual Sideshow standard affair that we've had before, magnetic clips on either side, and on the back we get a little bit of a snapshot from some of the scenes in the movie, albeit 10 seconds that he's in it, and we get a look at Neyo there, and that's that. Another picture on the other side, and there we go. Inside the box we have, as usual, two split layers. One contains the figure and one contains the weapon and spear hands, of which there are lots. If I zoom in just a little bit, oh, if I can let you see that, let me see if I can, there we go. There's some text if you want to freeze the screen. It's actually quite an interesting piece of info around Neyo there, which just gives you a bit of a background piece on his story. On this side here we get a bit of a yada yada around Star Wars itself. It's pretty standard on each box, I believe. Again, if you want to freeze frame, you can read all that. So on each side it has the figure and the weapons, as I mentioned. Just before I show you that, just on the underside, again, we've got that Hot Toys partnership. They're producing the guns and the weapons on this figure, and Sideshow is doing basically the actual action figure itself. So he comes with a standard rifle and one standard blaster pistol, along with two what I would call Captain Rex pistols, and we'll have a look at that right now. So inside the first tray, you've got a lot of hands going on here. So you've got a victory symbol, fingers pointing, as you can see, the overall large rifle. I'll take that and give you a shot, look at that in a second. All these different kind of hands, just if you want to use them. And of course the standard kind of running pose for Sideshow. I still don't like these things, but they seem to be getting a little smaller. Maybe it's me. They don't look quite as bad, but you get plenty of hands in here, plenty of weapons too. There's those standard blaster rifles we've shown many times before. I'll give you another quick look at it. And those two pistols, as I mentioned, the very Rex-like pistols that come with that. Just quickly pop that out. It's a shame the actual box itself is that pretty unexciting kind of design that's inside there, but look, let's not complain, it's still cool enough. There we go, the blaster rifle that most of these clones have. This one is incredibly brushed silver, as opposed to the more solid black, if I look at some of the other ones there that I've got in display. So definitely a real major silver wash over all these weapons themselves this time. Absolutely solid, it feels solid anyway. And all the detail on the handle, on the grip, those tiny little screws, every bit and piece of detail is there. Great piece to have. By now you've probably got a few spares, if you have, like me, a few Sideshow clones, so you can swap around. But there's those Rex pistols. I can't remember the exact name, but we'll put that in the details below. But you get two of them, two very sturdy pistols. Sadly, there's no way to store them, so you really can't do a great deal with that Neyo. You have to give him one of the other pose or rifle, and that's all you'll get. So just putting them to the side for a moment. There's nothing else inside the other side of the box. There is one other set of hands inside there that comes with fists. That's the default figure itself, is two hands with fists. But I've changed them out, and I've put on different hands here. One other thing quick to show you, standard Star Wars stand. If you wanted to, you could get the Sideshow exclusive. It's really just a coloured stand. It's not a great deal to write home about in my mind, but a lot of people like it, and it matches a kind of suite of other ones that have been out there. So it just it's a little bit overpriced for me, and I'm, well, it's the same price, but you've got to basically order these from Sideshow, and I can get a great supplier here in Australia, so I don't need to. So there's a standard stand. You basically sit the figure on the private parts and he displays, but let's get a look at him. So here's Neyo. First off, great weathering and paint on this figure, as usual by Sideshow. The detail is certainly there on this figure. As you can see, the weathering is full on. He's seen some battles and some scars around, and it's everywhere across the figure, but it looks good. It's well done. particularly on the red scuffed pauldron that he's got there on his shoulder. It's not really a pauldron, I guess. Here's an interesting point, just before we show you the rest of the figure. The backpack's quite different from other figures. It's more like the Coruscant landing platform trooper than any other clone we've seen before. Normally, I think from memory, the Coruscant landing review that we've done, we show an antenna that comes up, and this canister is something very similar in that backpack. Most of the clones don't have this kind of setup here, so we're getting something different for change, because for a while it's felt as if Sideshow were just rolling out all these clones, just a lick of paint and off they went, which rightly they kind of still are. But I'm not complaining, the figure is very good. Underneath the body is a super articulated true type kind of figure. Just about every pose you can imagine, every joint is flexible, bendable, movable. It's all pretty relatively unbreakable. It's not a toy, it is a poseable kind of collectible to display. But yeah, it's a fully articulated body, so as per all our Sideshow reviews, there's not much need to show you that the fact that the legs move and the bend, and yeah, every joint basically moves. There we go, right down to the feet. Still a bit too big for me, but they're getting better. I've got some other clones that just look crazy in terms of the size of the feet. Very muddy underneath wherever Neo is, and again, all that weathering, scorches, scrapes and scores is what he's got. Got a bit of cloth fabric going across here for this, I don't know what it is, strap that's holding on apparently nothing by the looks of it. He does have this extra side pauldron piece, but it does seem a bit of an unnecessary thing to have this brace over his shoulder, and it's holding nothing. So if anybody knows what that was for or why he has it, I have no idea. Maybe it was an ammo clip and he's empty, because we do get this small piece here, so maybe in the designs that's what was wrong with Neo. I have no idea, but anyway, it seems a bit of a redundant thing to have this almost seatbelt like thing over him. The thing to write home about is definitely the facial sculpt on this, and it is good. I'm pretty impressed with it. At first glance, I thought the teeth kind of grill part should have been a little bit darker and a bit more prominent with black paint in amongst them, but actually looking back on some of the stock photography in it, Revenge of the Sith, that's how it is. This helmet is very different. It's almost got these unannounced grooves in it with just a little bit of kind of weathering coming out of all the kind of holes along that helmet. But nicely done in terms of the paintwork, the visor is just wickedly cool, and that's really why I think everybody fell in love with this figure. He's been very popular that way. A little bit of yellow paint splodged around both ears for some reason I do not know. Again, if somebody knows, let me know. Has he been having a mustard sandwich to his ear, or I have no idea what the hell's going on. He's just, yeah, yellow on both sides. What's he doing? Yeah, some bugs or something. Great detail in the backpack. Loving all that kind of tiny, intricate details we get around his belt buckle. All these ammo pouches. It's all pretty cool. And of course, standard DC-15, I believe it is, rifle with the working stock. We've shown that again many times before. But a great looking rifle, and one that just never goes out of fashion on clones. It doesn't look incredibly big on him, but it's probably set to scale. I've got the finger pointing to the ear to get his order 66. And apart from that, that's it. But there are a couple of flaws on this figure, as some of the other Sideshow clones. I just want to point out to you, if you're thinking about this review just before you go and spend your money. The suit underneath, Sideshow still seem to be doing this thing. Very annoying piece on the thighs. These tend to fold down, and we get this effect here where we see a lot of thigh, and it just looks a little odd when they don't stay up. It's kind of hard. I've tried a couple of times, wedged a bit of cardboard sometimes up on that clone armor just to keep it up. It just looks a little odd. It's a shame it falls down. It'd be great if Sideshow could have put some Velcro or something in there to make it a little bit more. Less likely to slide down the armament, which is a little hard. Same for these shoulder kind of pauldrons here, you'll see there as well. There's a lot of the kind of ribbed suit underneath for the clone armour, and it's just the material slides down, so I do hope Hasbro Sideshow can one day maybe try and fix that a little if they can. Probably not, but I'm being hyper fussy. The other one here is Neo's neck. Now, forgive me if I'm wrong, let's see if you can get a look at this guy. It just seems, maybe I'm wrong, it seems like he's wearing a polo neck underneath this thing. It's almost like he's a little too tall. The armour seems to sit a little too short, and maybe I'm wrong, you tell me what you think, but it just seems to me the neck was a little too high. There was too much neck material and not enough armor further up. Again, it seems to be the part and parcel of the clone itself and that design, but tiny little flaws overall. It's a standard Sideshow clone. Not the cheapest thing in the world, but look, it's a rather cool piece. When you consider the busts alone for these guys, I have one or two of these busts that Gentle Giant made many years ago. They went for hundreds of dollars, so you might as well get yourself a 12-inch figure of this guy, because he's probably only going to go up in value. Being one of the cooler clones, he does look good. One of the things, just to show you the scale to this, and a little bit about this Hasbro figure, because I don't think we've ever given a review. There you go, there's the tiny little Neo. You can see the difference here in this figure. Oops, let me just pop him down there on his stand. And there we go. So you can see the detail is pretty accurate in terms for that 3 3/4 inch scale. Let me focus that up for you. And, you know, we get the belt braces, we get the shoulder patch, all the detail. Definitely got that grill piece going on the facial sculpt there. But otherwise, we get a very accurate kind of clone. This one's been out for many years. You've been repacked several times, order 66 packs, I think, and so forth. Not a removable helmet, but still a good clone nonetheless. So that's the 3 3/4 version 2 as a little bonus, just to show you. Yeah, look, he's pretty accurate, and so is the 12-inch counterpart here. But let us know what you think. Up above Neo's head is a subscribe button. In fact, no, it's changed now. It's down below Neo's chin. So if you want to hit that on YouTube, you get all our videos straight to your inbox. And let us know below what you think. Comments below or on Facebook.com/TechSushi. We're also on Twitter.com. So it's TechSushi. No, that's the other channel we do. Facebook.com/FlyGuy.net. And also on Twitter.com/FlyGuy. And you'll find us on Google+. Just search FlyGuy. So there you go. We'll see for more reviews coming up soon. But yeah, let us know what you think of Neil. Good, bad, meh. What the hell is that yellow on the side of his cheek? Who knows? We'll see you for more video reviews soon. Cheers.